The dawn is breaking, a light shining through. You're barely waking, and I'm tangled up in you.
Good evening, everyone. And welcome, welcome, welcome. What a glorious occasion this is to be a witness to the wedding of two beautiful people that I've met. And you know, when you interview them, you sort of get a feeling for how things gonna go. And I'm confident in these two right here. So for we begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Father, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers for Justin and Blair. With faith in you and in each other, they pledge their love today, and may their lives always bear witness to the reality of their love. And we ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Songs of Songs. Hark, my lover. Here he comes, springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle or a young stag. Here he stands behind our wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the lattices. My lover speaks. He says to me, arise, my beloved, my dove, my beautiful one, and come. Oh, my dove in the clefts of the rock and the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you. Let me hear your voice. For your voice is sweet, and you are so lovely. Oh, my dove in the clefts of the rock and the secret recesses. My lover belongs to me, and I to him. He says to me, let me as seal on your heart, as a seal on your arm, for he is stern as death is love, relentless as the netherworld is devotion. Its flames are a blazing fire. Deep waters cannot quench love. The word of the Lord.
Our responsorial psalm is, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from all fears. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Blessed the man who takes refuge in him. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. And blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. And blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Last night we had rehearsal, and I told them that what we practiced last night will not happen tomorrow. My little flower girl bailed out on me. The ring bird took a right turn. And but you gotta have them, rehearsals. But they are so, so beautiful. And it was cute last night because I guess she figured it out, because they bribed her last night with some goldfish crackers to come back. So she figured it out. They ain't gonna get me today. But what a beautiful day. I mean, it's, you know, every time I do weddings, I just feel good because it's, you know, we don't do them a lot no more. You know, people are not getting married. You know, they doing their own thing. You know, so when people come to me and say, "Deacon, you know, can you do our wedding?" You know, we meet and we talk and laugh and joke and play around just so I can get to know them. And now when I found out Justin Garth, the Supreme Court judges, I figured, well, he carries a gun, so ain't too much I'ma talk to him about. You know, and Blair with her always smiling face, you know. And I just felt good, you know, and when you feel good about something, you know, you want to be part of that. So thank you for asking me and to do y'all wedding. I really am thankful. But y'all picked out some beautiful, beautiful, beautiful readings. And they talk about love. And says, if you don't have love, you don't have nothing. And back in the day in the Old Testament, the story about Solomon, King Solomon, and he was a man who had everything. Mansions and concubines and 100 and some wives. And I mean, everything he wanted was there. But he wasn't happy because he didn't have love. When you fall in love with someone, your life changes. And I'm not gonna talk about mine, but that was like 30-some years ago. But it's still fun to me, though. But when you fall in love, you act all giggly, and you don't care about nothing else. All you wanna do is just be with that person as much as you can and let them know how precious they are, not only in your eyes, but in your heart. And when I looked at Justin one day, he had been playing basketball and hurt his legs. But I was watching him, and I watched how he looked at Blair. And I could see that little twinkle, you know, and I say, they're gonna be okay. Because y'all got that love. See, and that's what we look for. We, you know, we try to figure how this couple's gonna do later on. And I don't have no concerns. And like I said, y'all readings are so powerful. Because if you're not patient with one another and you're always mad and evil, then you're gonna be miserable. You know, and you know, you just don't want to be like that. You know, y'all gonna be sharing lives together, making decisions together, and as that gospel reading say, people are gonna hate you because you're not gonna be able to hang out with the boys like you used to. You know, Blair ain't gonna be able to go to the mall and spend all day shopping. You know, just, you know, things are gonna change. And that's when the love comes in, because you're making a sacrifice for each other. And it's a story about this man. He was like in his 80s, and he had cut his finger, and he had got it stitched up, and he had went to the doctor's office at 8 o'clock, because he was trying to get his stitches out, because he had a 9 o'clock appointment somewhere else. And the nurse looked at him and knew that there wasn't no way he was gonna get out there, you know, in time to make no 9 o'clock appointment. So she asked the doctor, she said, well, it looks good. Can I just take the stitches out? And the doctor said, sure, go right ahead. And she asked the old man, she said, well, do you have another appointment in the hospital? And he said, no. He said, but I gotta go have breakfast with my wife. And she said, oh, well, where's your wife? What's this? She said, oh, my wife is in the nursing home, and for the last 7 years, we had breakfast. We had breakfast at 9 o'clock, and I have to get there. And she said, oh, well, what's wrong with her? She said, oh, you know, she suffers with Alzheimer's. And she said, well, why do you go there? She said, do she recognize you? Do she know you? And he said, no, she don't know who I am. But I know who she is. She's the woman that I gave my life to. So regardless if she knows me or not, I know her. And I know the love that she gave me during her lifetime. Blair and Justin, that's what y'all gonna have to do. Share that love, share it abundantly, and be happy, glad, and joyful. And there's two things I learned in my 35 years of marriage. I'm telling my age. Two words that keep me out of trouble. Yes, dear. Works all the time. And I look at her sometimes and she, yes, dear. Pick you out a phrase to keep you out of trouble. But you know if it's working or not when she turned that anger into joy and laughter and say, boy, you know what, Justin, you better stop fooling with me like that. See, that's where you know you got love, son. And never go to bed angry. Never go to bed. For one thing, you can't sleep no way. You're gonna be up all night twisting and turning, and so don't even put yourself there. Just hug her and kiss her and say good night. Because that's what love is about. Loving, 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 loving. Boy, don't she look good? Gosh, don't I? Boy, I don't even have my glasses on. Well, here we go. My dear friends, you have come here together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church minister and this community. In this way, you will be strengthened to keep mutual and lasting fidelity with each other and to carry out the other duties of marriage. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Justin and Blair, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
I will.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your sympathy for God and this church. Repeat after me, son.
Okay.
I, Justin.
Take you, Blair. For my lawful wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better.
For worse.
For richer. For poorer. In sickness.
And in health.
Until death.
Until death.
Do us part.
You're
jumping the gun on
we
me.
We had a
son.
Rhythm.
Blair, repeat after me. I, Blair. Take you, Justin. For my lawful husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Good job.
You have declared your consent before the church. And may the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, man must not divide. You're going to give Justin her one. You know we on tape. You know that, right? This is very important.
Which way does it go?
That's right. Repeat after me, Justin. Blair.
Blair.
Take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Nice one there, too. Repeat after me, Blair. Justin.
Justin.
Take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. We'll now have our prayer of the faithful read by Jennifer. God has given us his promises in the word of scripture. Blair and Justin have given their promises to each other in their marriage. This hour of promise is also a time of prayer. We turn to our God and Father and make our responses by saying, Lord, have mercy.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Oh, okay.
I'm just following the script.
Well, he gotta have that too.
Mercy. True. Oh, for the leaders of the church and state, for heads of institutions, for heads of homes and households, that they will lead us and guide us in the search for God and the good life, in the search for peace and joy, in the search for love among us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all married people, for those married yesterday, for the new couple Blair and Justin married today, for those who will marry tomorrow, that they may savor the joy of being together, warm love and children, a long life, wine and friends, and a new day every day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all young single people who look forward to a vacation full of life and full of love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the lonely old and the lonely young, for the hungry rich and the hungry poor, for the sick in body, mind, and spirit, for the weakness in all of us, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our relatives and friends who walk with us on life's journey, and for those who have gone before us to the other side of life, for the fulfillment of all their unfulfilled desires, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
These are our words of prayer today, for ourselves and all human beings. Tomorrow there will be others. Lord God, the beloved of humankind, who has first loved us, give us our word by your listening, the power of your word, so that all things may be accomplished sweetly and gently for the happiness of all. Through Christ our Lord, amen. We will now light the unity candle. My dear brothers and sisters, in honor of Vlad and Justin on this great day, let us say the prayer that our Father in heaven has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. My dear friends, let us turn to the Lord and pray that he will bless for his grace this woman, Blair, now married in Christ, to this man, Justin, and that through the sacrament of the body and blood of Christ, he will unite in love the couple he has joined in this holy bond. Father, by your power, you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning, you created the universe and made mankind in your likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman so that man and women shall no longer be two, but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Father, you have made the union of man and wife so holy a mystery that it symbolizes the marriage of Christ and his church. Father, by your plan, man and women are united and married life has been established as the one blessing that was not forfeited by original sin or washed away in the flood. Look with love upon this woman, your daughter, now joined to her husband in marriage. She asks your blessings. Give her the grace of love and peace, and may she always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal, and that heir with him to the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children and help them to be good parents. And may they live to see their children's children. And after a happy old life age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. God, the eternal Father, keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may stay with you and be always in your home. Amen. And may your children bless you, your friends console you, and all men live in peace with you. Amen. And may you always bear witness to the love of God in this world so that the afflicted and the needy will find in your generous friends and welcome you into the joys of heaven. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Well, it's that time, son. For all of us to see. You may now salute your bride. Man, that was quick.
Beggars can't be choosers.
You fast guys, Jack. For the first time in public, Blair and Justin Ames.
Thank you. I can feel the magic floating in the air. Being with you gets me that way. I watch the sunlight dance across your face, and I've never been this swept away. All my thoughts just seem to settle on the breeze when I'm lying wrapped up in your arms. The whole world just fades away. The only thing I hear is the beating of your heart. And I can feel you breathe. It's washing over me. I can feel you breathe. Tumbling down, closer than I've ever felt before, and I know, and you know, there's no need for words right now.
To you, the parents of the bride, Robert and Stephanie Zeiler, and they're coming in with the flower girl and ring bearer, Reagan Kanaski and Josh Fisher. Come on, there they go. Now, let's welcome the parents of the groom, Ronald and Sherry Andes. Let's welcome bridesmaid Katie Napolillo, being escorted by Mr. Steven Sabarinick.
Best friends, you are my very best friends. Seriously, it's like the best night ever. This song, I'm really feeling this song. This song is like the best song.
Oh, all right, well, let's see what bridesmaids Sarah Korn and Mark Garrity are gonna do when they come in. now, bridesmaid Anna Carver, being accompanied by Mr. Ryan Kanaski.
I gotta tell ya, I gotta tell ya, best friends, you are my very best friends.
Seriously. Now let's welcome Lindsay Granger, being escorted by Mr. Matthew Rose. We have the matron of honor and also the bride's sister, Brooke Kanaski, being escorted by the best man and the groom's brother, Ryan Andes. It's an honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Andes.
Anyone else's favorite color, pink? I love you, Blair. I want to thank Bob and Stephanie, Ron and Sherry for making everything possible, our lovely bridesmaids, our groomsmen for showing up sober. those of you who don't know me, my name is Ryan Andes. I'm Justin's slightly older brother. If you couldn't tell from all our physical attributes there. I'll keep this short and sweet. See, I'm boring some people already. But,
it's okay.
I know. I mean, it seems like yesterday we were playing soccer in the living room, basketball in the basement. I would block every shot you put up. And then he turned 10. And basketball wasn't fun anymore after that. But I think the dog used to play too, because Dad was always fixing broken lights and lamps. And we would be hiding in the corner pointing, you know, the dog, go, Daddy, don't beat me, you know? But I mean, it happened so quick, you know? It's like you grew up overnight, you know? You're about 13 when I moved out the first time. And about 3 months later, I came back to do my laundry. That happens quarterly. And I look up to him for the first time and be like, hey. And I'm, you know, thinking, it's probably a good time to stop picking on him, you know? He finally hit that little growth spurt there. Boom. But it seemed like it happened overnight, man. Yeah. You got an amazing woman in Blair over here. I mean, she might not have made the best color selection, but your husband's selection was spot on, though. I gotta give you that.
What? Husband selection?
Her selection and husband was spot on, bro. I mean, hey, you at a buffet, you might make one food selection to be happy, but Blair, you're like his chicken nuggets. You know, you're all he'll ever need, so. Yeah. Honestly, I couldn't be more happy for you, too. I've never known, you know, a better match in my entire life. You know, it is my honor, you know, to welcome you to the Andes family. You know, congratulations to you, too.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, buddy.
Thank you very, very much, Ryan.
I'm Blair's sister, Brooke, just to clear things up. I hope everyone's having a good time tonight. Thanks for coming and joining us in this celebration. I just want to start off this about saying how proud I am of both of you and how far you've come since almost the 7 years ago today that you guys went to your first prom together. Who would have thought we'd be standing here tonight? But I just want to say it's so good to see you guys grow up together. You guys have become like amazing young adults. I'm so proud of the nurse you've become, and you know, you both have worked so hard to get where you are, and I'm just very proud of both of you. Justin, I'm really excited to have you as a brother. You know, you'll have to handle some beatings by Virginia Tech and, you know, suck it up in football and in basketball now, too, unfortunately. you know, you guys are so perfect for each other. I mean, when Blair told me they were going out to celebrate their engagement, I was like, oh, you know, they're going to go to a really fancy dinner. They're going to go out downtown with their friends. No, they went to Dave and Buster's to play games. But that pretty much just describes Blair and Justin. I mean, they just, they're always doing fun things together, sports, games, you know. And I just couldn't think of anyone more perfect for my sister. So I just want to toast to Blair and Justin. Yeah.
Hi, let's all go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we give you such glory and praise for this opportunity to be here and celebrate this wedding of Justin and Blair. It is such a wonderful occasion that only you could lead two people, two wonderful people together like this. You crossed their paths together so they would meet. You let their love build slowly. You guided them through long-distance relationship and time together. And Lord, it was your love. And as your word says, love is never self-serving. Love is slow to anger. And love never keeps a history of wrong things. And that is the love that they share. And let this love guide them through their days as they turn into years. And Lord, we want to thank you so much for having Jesus here with us tonight. For as in your word, you say that when two or three together are gathered in Jesus' name, he is here with us. And we thank you so much for bringing him here for this wonderful, wonderful celebration. Lord, we thank you for this wonderful meal you're about to present to us. We thank all of the people who have worked so hard to prepare this evening. We bless all of them and ask you to bless them. Thank you so much for guiding everyone safely here. And we ask you to guide them safely home again this evening. And Lord, may your spirit of wisdom guide Blair and Justin as they go through their years. And may you fill them with the Holy Spirit so it guides them through everything that they do. And we thank you for this meal, and please bless this food for the nourishment of our bodies. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Well, you done me, and you bet I felt it. I tried to beat you, but you're so hot that I melted. I fell right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to get back. Before the cool done run out, I'll be giving it my bestest. And nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some or learn some. But I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours. One big family, and it's our God-forsaken right to be loved, 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 loved. So I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm sure there's no need to complicate our time. Checking my tongue in the mirror and bending over backwards just to try to see it clearer, but my breath fogged up the glass, and so I drew a new face and I laughed. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid yourself of vanities and just go with the seasons. It's what we aim to do. Our name is our virtue. But I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours. Open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn, you're free. I look into your heart and you'll find that the sky is yours. So please don't, please don't, please don't. There's no need here to complicate. 'Cause I'm time.
Everybody, let's have a nice warm welcome for Justin and Blair. They selected a song by Jason Mraz entitled, I Won't Give Up.
When I look into your eyes, it's like watching the night sky or a beautiful sunrise. Well, there's so much they hold. And just like them old stars, I see that you've come so far to be right where you are. How old is your soul? Well, I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I'm giving you all my love. I'm still looking up. When you're needing your space to do some navigating, I'll be here patiently waiting to see what you find. Even the stars, they burn. Someone who walks away so easily. I'm here to stay and make the difference that I can make. Our differences, they do a lot to teach us how to use the tools and gifts we got. Hey, we got a lot at stake. And in the end, you're still my friend. At least we did intend for us to work. We didn't break, we didn't burn. We had to learn how to bend without the world caving in. I had to learn what I got and what I'm not and who I am. I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I'm giving you all my love. I'm still looking up, still looking up. The skies get rough. I'm giving you all my love. I'm still looking up.
Blair and Justin.
Blair and Justin, we're so, so happy for you guys. We're having a great time tonight and wish you all the happiness in the world. We're so excited for you guys to start your new life together.
We're really, really proud, Blair, everything you've done. Justin, you got a great girl, and we feel the same that, Blair, you got a great guy, and we know everything's going to be great, and can't wait to for the years ahead. So best of luck, and have a great time on your honeymoon.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment, and each other's face. So much in love, you're alone in this place. Like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her, not long. ago, I was her number one. She told me so, and she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. How could that beautiful woman wed you, be the same freckle faced kid that I knew, one that I read all those fairy tales to, and tucked into bed all those nights. And I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. Someday you might know what I'm going through, when a miracle smiles over you. I loved her first.
Blair, an extremely proud father, Bob.
Hi, Blair. Hi, Justin. What a wonderful, wonderful day this is. God is so good, and he's brought you two together, and now I have a daughter, and I'm just looking forward to life ahead with you guys. I love you.
Hey, Justin, Blair, we're just so proud of you. Had a great celebration, and we just hope that everything just comes together in your new life together, and we're just so happy to have you be part of our family, and we're looking forward to some great things to come, and we'll be expecting that in the near future. We love you.
Watch us where we go, and help us to be wise in times when we don't know. Let this be our prayer when we to a place, guide us with your grace to a place where we'll be safe.
La luce che tu dai,
I pray we'll find your light,
nel cuore resterà,
and hold it in our heart,
ricordarci.
When stars go out each night,
eterna stella sei, nella mia preghiera,
let this be our prayer,
quanta fede c'è.
Faith so we'll
Ladies and gentlemen, Justin and his extremely proud mom, Sherry. Cha-cha again. Cha-cha now, y'all.
Coming out. Poke at it. Yeah, there you go. now. Drop it on there. Hey.
Justin is going to perform his first husbandly duty in front of all these people. And there it is. How did he do? He did great, right?
Especially not if your wife is married.
All right. Do you see how much more intense the guys are than the girls were? All right, we're gonna need your help on this. Everybody, we're gonna need to count to three. So here we go, are you ready? Here we go, 1, 2, 3. Great effort, guys.
You got it, man.
Good work.
This is Brian. And this is Katie. Everybody say hello. Do they know each other? Yeah, they do. Yes, they do. They are engaged. Okay? So, but they're getting married. Alright. So. Now, Brian, this is very, very important. What you hold in your hands is actually Blair and Justin, married future. How long will they be married? That will be determined about how far Katie's ankle, knee, hip, thigh, okay? Okay, that means at least 15 years that they're gonna be married. You wanted to be married a long time, Brian, so go ahead. All right, go on, everybody, clap your hands, clap around. Give a little encouragement.
We're milking it right now. We're milking it.
That's right, doesn't matter who dances with who.
My fear apart, and that laugh.
Once you party with us, you'll be falling in love. California girls were unforgettable. Daisy Duke's bikinis on top. Sun-kissed skin so hot, we'll melt your popsicle.
Come on, come on, say you will see that.
Crowd. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for everything you've done. This night has turned out absolutely perfect. It's everything we could have wished for.
Yeah, thank you, my parents and her parents, for this night. It was fabulous. It went too quickly, really.
Like, it really did.
We got a late start, but even then, it still was too quick. And thank you for being my beautiful bride.
From this moment, life has begun. From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment on, from this moment, I have been blessed. I live only for your happiness and for your love. I'd give my last breath from this moment on. I give my hand to you. Can't wait to live my life with you. I can't wait to start. You and I will never be apart. My dreams came true because of you. From this moment, as long as I live from